Welcome, my dear students. Today we'll be dealing with a new chapter, Systems of Particles and Rotational Motion. In this module, let us discuss about a rigid body and translational and rotational motion. So let us discuss first, what is meant by system of particles? It means a well-defined collection of a large number of particles which may or may not interact with each other or connected to each other. A rigid body is a body in which the distance between any two particles always remains a constant. So rigid body is a body in which the distance between all pairs remain constant throughout its motion. Now let us discuss about rigid bodies and translational motion and rotational motion. A rigid body may have translational motion, rotational motion, or a combination of both. It may also roll without slipping. So the figure A shows its translational motion, that means motion along the x-axis. Rotational motion means it will be rotating along a particular axis. And rolling means it will be having both translational and rotational motion. This is the case of a body which is having pure translational motion. That is, along a slope, the object is sliding. That is, it is having only translational motion. In the case of rotational motion, it will be rotating about a particular axis. Considering any point on the body, it will be executing a circular motion, or the path covered by any point on the object will be circular in nature. This is the example of a pedestal fan, which is an example for precessional motion. That means here, if it is oscillating, then the axis of rotation will not be fixed. So in this case, if there is rotation and if the axis is not fixed, we can call it as precessional motion. The movement of a top is also an example for precessional motion, since its axis may vary as it rotates. Now, taking into consideration any two points P1 and P2 on an object which is rotating about the Z axis, we can see that the distance of this particle from the axis of rotation always remains constant. That is, it will be circulating in a circle of radius R1 and R2 respectively. Hope you might have got an idea about rigid body, rotational and translational motion. Thank you, dear students.